In case you have not joined our social media handle, what are you waiting for? Kindly go ahead and subscribe, like, comment, share, and also remember to on your notification button so that whenever our news drop, you will be the first. We'll collect and make we go for the news proper. The information will be see it carry us come here. Gunmen kill community vigilante. Don't shell it. The UGM don't return their activities again. Because everybody was expecting that by now it is either that Mas Nnamdi Kanu has been released, or either that Peter Obi becomes the president of Nigeria. But to the surprisingness of everybody, that has not been the case. Oga Tinubu is still in office, and Peter Obi then has gone to the tribunal, Norway, and he is saying that they are going to the Supreme Court. Let's go down to that information, make we see waiting they happen and when this Obodode go day good. Because from waiting they sub now, Obodode in good is something that is under consideration. Because I say a lot of them are not around this. A member of vigilante group at First Marine Gate Quarters in Warri South local government area of Delta State, identified simply as Wilson, was shot dead in the early hours of Monday by gunmen. Punch Me Through gathered that the gunmen engaged the community vigilante group in a gun duel, during which some members of the vigilante team fled due to the superior firepower of the attackers. Consequently, one vigilante man, Wilson, was felled by bullets from the invading gunmen. Even though details of the incident are sketchy, the corpse of the deceased, covered with a white cloth, remained by the roadside at the scene of the incident for several hours in the morning, while passersby and residents caught a glimpse as of the time of writing this report. The State Command Police Relations Officer, DSP Bright Edafe, could not be reached for comments on the incident as of the time of filing this report, as text and calls put to his mobile phone were neither replied nor answered. My people, the main thing is that the government is the architecture of whatever insecurity, whatever banditry, whatever that is happening in this Obodo. The government is they are the architecture. Why did I say they are the architecture? You are there as a president, there in the office. You are not creating any job opportunity for the people, especially for the youth. Idle man is the devil's workshop. Anyway, when you see man, the way they idle, now they devil, they carry building workshop, because that man, devil go use and do all the kind of tool where we say he want use and do, because he no get work. Person will no get work, he no get work. And I had a man's workshop. The government of the nation has decided to be squandering the money of the economy. You see them riding Land Cruisers, riding Lamborghinis, bulletproof cars, and the rest of them. A house, living in a house is worth millions, sending their children abroad to study, while the poor masses are there languishing in their poverty. Meanwhile, these resources that are being squandered by few political elites are resources meant for everybody in the nation. Now, why is it that only few political elites have access to these resources? If you graduate from school and you are looking for a job opportunity, they will not tell you to go and bring 5 years experience. How are you going to be getting 5 years experience when you just graduated from school? If you look the matters where we say if they happen for this Obodo, and if they carry them out the chuka, sometimes what thing go they do you for body we say make you they cry. But the thing we say you go cry finish, shout finish, you go see say the leader where we say then carry give you those people and people where they call Ndi Obiakpo. Ndi Obiakpo, because they don't have time to hear their citizens out. They don't even have time to even know what you are doing, or what will benefit you, or what will even benefit the nation. All they know is that let them have the money and have the bag, And once they have the money and have the bag, forget it. Every other thing is what is called back for me. Over that jaw and jaw. But meanwhile, don't give hope. Don't give up until the final whistle. People are still waiting to see what is going to happen. That's the thing. People are still waiting to see what is going to be the turnout of events in this nation. What is going to be the turnout of events? Many people are unhappy. Now let's go down to Imo State so that you can see what is happening. Hoodlums burn Imo monarch's house and vehicles. Yet to be identified armed hoodlums have set ablaze the palace of the traditional ruler of the Ndianiche Arondizio community in the Idato North local government area of Imo State, Eze Kalu Ikenolu. His vehicles and properties were not spared when the hoodlums stormed the home of the monarch in the early hours of Sunday and threw explosives into the mansion. The monarch narrowly escaped death as the hoodlums did not meet him at home when they arrived at his palace. The Nations reported a villager who pleaded anonymity for security reasons said that properties worth millions were destroyed by the hoodlums. The villager also expressed frustration over the police. Over the police delay response as they were informed that the hoodlums were storming the monarch residence. The palace of His Royal Highness Eze Ikenolu, the Eze of Ndianiche Arondizio, has been invaded by the government and the people are in the bushes now. Until now, no response from the police to stop the hoodlums from further destruction of the palace of His Royal Highness Eze Kanu, where cars, houses, and properties worth millions of naira were destroyed. Anytime Arondizio is under siege, the police hardly come to the people's rescue. It makes us also wonder if the place is no longer part of Imo State, he said. Confirming the incident, the Imo police spokesperson Henry Okoye said efforts were on to arrest the perpetrators. Okoye said frantic efforts are on top gear to arrest the assassins and bring them to justice. Una don't see as it happen. It dey shell everywhere one by one. This one, mama go collect, papa go collect, brother go collect, sister go collect, traditional rulers go collect. But one thing, the paramount thing here is that let the traditional rulers, let the politicians, let them try and better the government of this nation. Because I will still go down to issue of saying that everything that is happening is because of what is called irresponsibility of the government. The government are like children, are like parents that are giving back to children and gladly refuse to face their responsibility. Because these citizens are your responsibility. We were told that the first assignment of the government is to give security to the people, protect life and properties, provide social amenities, provide good education, provide road infrastructure, and the rest of them. But these things are what people are not even seeing in Nigeria. And every day, you see allocation for yearly budget for the year running in trillions. Then you will be asking yourself, what actually is this money being used for? Where is this money invested? You go and check that the senator in your own constituency have collected the money. Then you'll be wondering, okay, now the money has been collected from the senator in my own constituency. What is he using the money for? Nothing. Nothing come out. They will raise a bill in the house. When the bill is passed, after the third passing, that third reading of the bill, they see the Senate and the president assenting the bill as a law. And you will be waiting or assenting the bill to assenting the motion. You will be watching, okay, this motion has been moved, assented by the legislatures. When is it going to be carried out? So if you talk the things where we say it concerns this nation, my brother, on Agodiakwa. So meanwhile, I go to wind down the curtain here. And if this is your first time of joining us on this wonderful channel, kindly go ahead and subscribe, like, comment, and share.